as you can see, this massive tusker is just standing in the most stunning spot. I mean, you can see the bamboo in the backdrop, the golden evening light behind him. You couldn't have a better setting for this tusker.
Now, this particular individual is called Thump, and he's actually a regular around these parts. He's quite calm around people, which is probably why I'm so confidently standing that close to a wild elephant. But he's a regular, we see him pretty often.
Thump as an individual would be around 35 to 40 years old, and he's in his prime.
Now let's take a closer look at him.
If you look at his tail, it's actually cut from the end. And this is probably due to some sort of a confrontation that he had with another tusker.
So if you look at Thump right now, because we have a clear view, you can see that his left tusk is actually a little lifted. And that's what we generally look out for when we look at a tusker to identify Thump. And just look at him as he rubs his legs against the grass and he's taking off the small, new, fresh grass shoots that have come out, and he's eating them right now. And he's actually dusting the mud off that tiny, small pieces of grass and eating that.
Just then, things got a little bit more exciting.
On my right, as you can see, there's a massive male tusker standing there. And to my left, there's a beautiful, majestic male god standing there.
I feel pretty amazing right now. I have two massive animals on either side of me. And together, they probably form about 4 tons of muscle. And here I am standing between them, 60 kilograms. It's absolutely incredible.
That's the rutting call of a male god. When this fails, the males size each other up and lock horns. Gaur males are best told by their impressive muscular build, glossy black coat and white socks. Females and juveniles are much smaller and browner. The males are usually solitary or stay at the edge of the herd and very rarely move among the females and young. We very often see Gaur herds grazing at the forest edge, but that is not the case with the more secretive elephants. However, we did get lucky a couple of days back when we came across a herd at the Salt Lake. It was a very special encounter. There were 5 females and 2 subadult tusked bulls. Now, unlike in African elephants, Asian elephant females lack tusks, and the males can either be tusked or tuskless males, which are locally known as makhnas. Now, it's always interesting to come across a herd in the open, and that is the best time to truly understand the dynamics within the group. We noticed that the matriarch, the large female, kept chasing away the young bulls. And after a while, we realized why. The baby, almost invisible except when we had our binoculars on, was just a few weeks old and was constantly shielded by the other females. We also saw that it already had a fresh wound from a tusk, probably inflicted by one of the boisterous bulls. It's no wonder that these young bulls are forced to leave the herd and lead a solitary life. As the herd melted back into the woods, we are brought back to Thump, our not-so-boisterous solitary bull elephant.
Thump has now gone towards the bamboo at the back. Monsoon time, the rains have come in, so new shoots of bamboo have come out. And elephants absolutely love them. So, I'm going to take a closer look at what he's up to.
Thump is eating away. You can see him actually ripping down that bamboo, and it's so loud. Wow, just look at that. He is a massive creature. Wow, you can see him twirling his trunk around it. So you can see him use his trunk and maneuver it around the bamboo and yank that massive bamboo down. Just look at his strength. Look at that. Let's see what he's doing now. He's actually eating all the tender small leaves on that bamboo. Elephants are just incredible. We've been watching this elephant for a long time now. And Thump has always been fantastic around people. He is very calm. But I feel like I should leave him be now. He's peacefully eating his bamboo and it took a lot of effort to pull that thing down. So I'm guessing he's going to hang around and eat it for a while. I don't want to disturb him any further. So let's leave him in peace and let him eat his bamboo.